the Cowboys taking on the Rams. Rams would jump out to an early lead in this one. Todd Gurley makes it 20-7 on the 35-yard touchdown run. He and C.J. Anderson both had over 100 yards rushing on Saturday. Cowboys hung around, though. A little over 2 minutes left to play. Dak Prescott runs in for the score, cuts the lead to 8. That would be it. Rams wouldn't give the ball back. Jared Goff picks up the 3rd and 7. That would seal it. Final score, Rams win 30-22. Here's Dak Prescott after the loss.
It's been a great season, obviously, just all the ups, all the downs. The team that we had are 3-5 and being counted out by everyone, but backs against the wall mentality, the way we were able to fight just to get to where we are right now is inspiring and incredible. All the men on this team, I'm proud of this team, but anytime you lose, especially when you know the team that we have and as close as we felt we were, it's not a good feeling.
What's it feel like to win a playoff game?
Feels good.
Besides that?
Feels good.
Really good?
Real, real, real good. Great, actually.
Okay.
But this ain't we still got one more. Keep winning. We gotta keep winning.
All right, Coach, how are the Rams able to avoid the upset against a Cowboys team who really had more of the momentum coming into this one?
Yeah, they just out-cowboyed the Cowboys and did everything that the Cowboys didn't want them to do. They got up to a 23-7 lead at halftime. They were able to run the ball effectively. They took away the running game. They controlled the clock. It was all everything that you expected on the Cowboys stat line is what the Rams did to the Cowboys. And that to me was the most surprising part of this game. And all that being said, Dallas still had a chance. You know, 4th and 1 to start the fourth quarter, they stopped Zeke, and then even late when they had that drive, if they could have just pushed it along, it felt like that last drive took forever. They still had a chance, but I did not see this playing out this way, and I don't think anybody did in terms of just the lopsided running game statistics.
I don't think anyone is shocked that the Rams won, but the style in which they won, where Dallas can't get to Jared Goff at all throughout the game. Dak actually plays a pretty good game, but Zeke has his least productive high usage game of his college or pro career. 49 times in Zeke's career, he's had at least 22 touches. This is the fewest yards per touch and the fewest overall yards he's ever had in that instance. And the Cowboys were not playing a great run defense. They weren't playing the Saints. They dodged the Saints. We thought they dodged a bullet in that. They were playing a team whose biggest weakness was their run defense, and they could not run the ball effectively. Conversely, the Cowboys, who had only allowed 4 70-yard rushers all year, allowed 2 guys in the first half to get over 70 yards. C.J. Anderson, no, C.J. didn't see this coming. Nobody could have seen C.J. Anderson being the player of the game in the first half, and we know how good Todd Gurley is. So I think you put it perfectly, that the Rams took what we thought would have been the Cowboys' game plan and just executed it way better than the Cowboys could.
You can tell that the bye week was a huge asset for the Rams, and their big ticket items, and Ndamukong Suh, Aaron Donald, they took it upon themselves, because I know Wade Phillips. He's coached on teams that I've been on, and he personally likes to challenge, especially his star players. And I guarantee you, he challenged them to the Ezekiel Elliott and this running attack that Dallas has. But I think that in watching the game, everyone hears about Dallas, but if you watch them, their offensive line has been question marks all season. They missed Travis Frederick at center, best center that we have. All right, they've had other guys who missed, but that interior part of that offensive line is not nearly as good. High draft pick Connor Williams from Texas, he was forced into starting this game, and you can see his struggles during the season, earlier in the season when he struggled. Oh, and Ndamukong Suh, they ate up the center and the guard gaps. The penetration into the backfield was a constant theme for the Rams, so that's how the Rams were able to play like the Cowboys and out-cowboy the Cowboys in this game, Coach.
And when you look at that defense for the Rams, they got out to such a good start during the course of the season, and you've got a lot of guys making a ton of money who are veteran guys who might have went into cruise control defensively in the latter part of the season, When you get in the playoffs, it's a totally different animal. And those guys weren't worse players. Those guys are really good players. It felt to me like in the latter part of the Rams season, a lot of those defensive guys made business decisions, said we're going to be in the playoffs. We're going to be the one or the two seed, and I'm going to save myself for that. And that's what it felt like.
Well, and if that was the, I mean, because this was, we said it on Friday, the biggest game Ndamukong Suh's ever played in. And he had been, I think, relatively speaking, disappointing for them with the 1 year, $14 million. They get him to pair next to Aaron Donald, and they still have a bottom five run defense. This was the best game he's played as a Ram. Like, he was all over the backfield. He was a big reason Zeke didn't get going. He was great in this game. So maybe, and he would be the first guy that I think of when you say a veteran player making a bit of a business decision late in the season. That would make a lot of sense with him.
The cornerbacks and their coverages, they were not. They're part of that group. And when you're a veteran player, a hired gun, you're trying to win one season, you're driven a lot by your stats. So at the end, if you don't have stats, I need to get to the playoffs healthy. They were able to get the bye week, now get into the divisional round. They had a perfect matchup because they could play man-to-man on the outside and help those linebackers by putting another safety in the box. But penetration at the line of scrimmage was the difference in this attack.
When we looked at this, go ahead.
Well, I was just going to say those stat lines, you're looking at sacks. Not a lot of people, you can't quantify the run defense to an individual. Mm-hmm. So guys, you know, when they're doing that evaluation,
that's a great point.
Those numbers aren't as important to the guys looking for contracts as opposed to sacks, quarterback pressures, interceptions, things like that.
We looked at this game coming in. We said, okay, they both have two great running backs that have dominated this season. We looked at, you know, two great defenses that were going up against each other. And then we looked at these two third-year quarterbacks. And we said, well, who's going to come out and have the bigger game? I don't know. Dak Prescott didn't have a bad game. Jared Goff didn't have a bad game. Who played better between the two?
Well, that's why we put too much emphasis on the quarterback. This was the game that wasn't about the quarterbacks. Like, which guys? Now, you want to try to force the game. Jared Goff would have been involved in the game if I don't get 600 yards rushing or whatever CJ and them had. I mean, but you never got a chance to force that third-year quarterback into playing. So Jared Goff's numbers aren't outstanding, but in the playoffs, it's about getting on the winning bus. So they didn't have to. Dak, you have to be pleased with how he played when they were down. He wasn't forcing. He wasn't making mistakes. So Dak, you got to be pleased with his growth. Goff is still going to be forced next week in New Orleans because they're going to score some points. They got a balanced attack, not like Dallas. So next week will be the test for that Rams.
And look, in Dallas, they're spending this time now, and I'm sure they're going to have to sit down with ownership and explain how Ezekiel Elliott gets held to 47 yards against that defense. There's going to be some people that are going to have to answer that question. How does that happen? And then on the flip side, how do you give up 273 yards rushing to this offense? And look, I'm not taking anything away from CJ, but that's not what you're expecting. So there's some questions that are going to have to be answered this week with ownership as to how could this play out this way?
Well, the reason why they need better interior defensive tackle play. That's what they have to look at. The Cowboys do. The linebackers weren't able to roam and dominate the game the way they were. Offensive line of the Rams, one of the biggest improvement stories. Andrew Whitworth getting his first playoff win, coming after seven losses in Cincinnati and then losing last year with the Rams. He was 0-8 in his playoffs. So that Rams offensive line has really improved.
All right, Coach, stick around. Coming up, how are the Patriots able to dominate the Chargers? That's next. This is First Things First.
Coach Mangini whiffed on his pick on this.